Push harder than yesterday if you want a different tomorrow. If you have certain goals in life, certain aspirations, certain objectives which you want to fulfill, then you really need to work hard for the same. You need to put in a lot of efforts today, work really, really hard so that you can have a better future. So there is a need of some kind of a urge, some desire which will encourage you to work hard. That urge, that desire which comes from within, which is actually encouraging you to work hard, to achieve certain things in life, to succeed in life, that urge is called motivation. There have been different theorists who have expressed their views on motivation. And today we are going to discuss one such theory which was given by Abraham Maslow. What he had to say was that people are motivated by needs. They have different needs which motivate a person. There are some lower level needs and some higher level needs. So once the lower level needs are satisfied, then the person will move to next higher level need, and that very need will motivate a person. If one need is fulfilled, then that need is no more going to motivate a person. Just think of the times where you were children and your parents used to motivate you to study. What they did? They told you that study hard, score good marks, we'll buy a video game for you. Or you study hard, you score good, we'll buy a new laptop for you. So these were materialistic things which used to motivate us at that point in time. Now when we are looking for good career opportunities, we are willing to work hard, put in lot of efforts towards our preparations for SEBI, RBI, IAS, because we want good career growth in life. We want to reach that position, work in a reputable post, work as the grade A officers, grade B officers, the IAS officers. So that very position, that very career, that success which will come when we will become such officers is something which is motivating us to work really, very hard. So what Maslow said was that there are five different levels of needs. Some needs are lower level needs, some are more higher level needs. And these needs are going to motivate a person. So the most basic need which he talked about is the physiological need. This is the most basic need, the need of food, clothing, shelter. So we need some things in life to sustain our life. These are the things which will motivate a person first. Think of all those poor people out there, poor sections of the society who are not even having the money to buy two-time meal per day for their family. So being able to buy food for their family, clothes for their family, a house to stay, a shelter for them is the thing which is going to motivate them to work really hard. So there are some daily laborers who are working to get two-time meal for their family. So that is something that's motivating them. Once that need is fulfilled, it's no more going to motivate a person. If a person has been working in that very position for a long period of time, he's able to get some food, clothing, shelter for himself, for his family, then he will no more be motivated by that need. Then comes the next level need, which is the safety need. A person wants safety from any kind of emotional or physical harm. He wants himself to be protected. Okay, so if you are working somewhere, the environment should be such that your health is maintained, the environment is secure, you are having job security. So when you are working on daily basis, now you will want that I want some permanent job, some job security. You would like to take some insurance for yourself so that when you are medically unfit, that insurance can help you out. Okay, you will take a life insurance so that after you, there is someone to take care of your family. So all these efforts, for achieving all these things in life, you put in a lot of efforts. So safety needs are the next level needs which motivate a person. Once this need is fulfilled, then a person will have some other needs that will motivate him. So that other level of need is the need of belongingness, the need of love, care, affection. You want friendly relations with others, cordial relations. You must be in good communication terms with others. If such a thing is not happening, you will be stressed out. You would not like to work. You would not like to do the things you are doing. So mental satisfaction is something which is really important, and that is going to motivate a person. If you are working at one place where you are not having you're not into good terms with your colleagues, with your boss, you would like to shift your job, switch over to elsewhere because you need that belongingness, those friendly relations with others. So this shows that the need for love, care, affection, belongingness, having good relations, being in good talking terms with others is something which motivates a person to work really hard. When this need is also fulfilled, then a person has even more higher level needs, that is the self-esteem need. The need for respect, recognition, growth is the self-esteem need. You want to earn some respect. You want to be rewarded for the good things you are doing. You look forward for growth. Suppose you are working for 2 years in some firm. You are not getting any increments. You are not getting any promotions. You are not satisfied with the kind of working environment over there. You want more growth in your career. So you will switch over to some other job. And for switching over, you will really work hard. You might be working in a bank as a PO. Now you want growth. So you will look forward giving more banking exams to be able to achieve great heights. So that is the growth need, the need for recognition, which will motivate you to work really hard. Then comes the last and the highest level need. That's the self-actualization. That means realizing your ultimate potential. Whatever maximum capacity you have within you to do something, you reach that position. Okay, so once you reach that position, you get the ability to solve problems, to be creative, you are satisfied, and that kind of a situation motivates you and you calmly continue to work. So this is the highest possible need. This is how Maslow described different needs which motivates a person. These are some lower level needs, and as we move up the pyramid, the level of needs becomes even higher.